Hello, and welcome back. Today's video is a new journal share. You cannot see it here because I want to explain a little bit before I show you the journal. Yes, the disclaimer, it's a longer video, sorry. But let me tell you a little bit. I made some notes because a friend, a lovely friend, has asked me to do a journal for her. Usually I don't take many custom orders. They mean personally, they mean a little bit pressure because I want to be perfect and I like to make my journals with a free mind and no pressure and whatever I want to do. So not much custom orders or orders itself. But this lovely friend has asked me and I couldn't say no to her. She's so sweet. She wanted to have a journal for a friend, so this journal will be for a friend of a friend. I got some things that I have to include. She wanted a specific kit from Calco Collage. It's autumn themed, and she has chosen to go with the Autumn Ride from Calco Collage. I will link it in the description box. So she said the favorite colors are yellowy, orange, reddish, so autumn themed colors. Okay. She wanted a fabric cover, autumn themed. Okay. And a journal with a spine. So that means no one signature journal. It means at least two or three signatures to get a spine. So she wanted it grungy and she wanted ferns and she wanted some of my mushroom embellishments and eco-dyed paper in it. So okay. And then she said she wanted a dangly ding dong on the spine, autumn themed charms. Okay. And then she said she wanted it all as a planner. Yay. So first I thought, whoa, tough order. Okay. The first 2 days I was thinking. but I think I got it done because let me stand up for this. I made one. I made this one. That's the best planner so far I ever made because I never made a planner before. Yay! but I loved to do it. So this is the planner. It has a spine, so you can see it has five signatures, 176 pages or 172, I'm not sure. And 5 weeks per signature makes 25 weeks as a planner. 25 weeks is a lot, but I got it done. So let me show you this here. This is oh, this is a little bit bright here. It is in real a little bit darker. So I have fluffy and grungy and fluffy stuff here everywhere. I'm not sure if you can see it here. You will see it when I flip through. Here I added on this tabs here. I added charms and fabric and leaves. These are these fabric leaves. I'm pretty sure it's not really fabric. That's the cover. So let me use the ruler. The measurements are 6 inches by 8.5, and the spine 2-inch spine. So I purchased the fabric and this fabric. I think it's really cute, and yeah, I built this cover. It's a hard cover. I built this cover out of a bookboard, so it's not a hardcover book, and I've just covered it. I built this from bookboard myself. Let me show you the back side Gorgeous, gorgeous fabric. The closure here with eyelets. It's a chunky one. And now I want to show you the charm. Dangly ding dong. This is this one. Let me stand it here. So it's attached here with a bobby pin. And we have here a leaf, a fox, a sunflower, squirrel, acorn, a snail, a tree, another leaf. Here is a mushroom, a bunny, and a bird, and some beads. And you can hear there's a bell. So this is the Dingley Ding Dong charm with autumn themed charms. They were all bronze, but I wanted a variety of colors. So the bronze goes well with autumn as a little bit of greenish. And then the bronze charms I have changed the colors into copper. I think that's great. So here on the front, this collage. Here in the background, some cardstock stamped with some script stamping. Then you can hardly see it. This is in a vintage book page. Here's one of these fabric leaves. This is an image from Calco Collage. I have added here a mushroom, and this is also bits and pieces from a piece from Calco Collage's kit, and this is also from her. So let me open this big dude. So the closure is sari ribbon. Come on. Oh, come on. Yes. Okay. So it's a little bit chunky. Wish. But five signatures and lots of stuff in there. So when the person wants to write in the journal, you can just make this charm to this side. So grungy, grungy, grungy. It should be grungy. Here in the front, this gorgeous fabric that I also have on the spine. And this pocket, this fabric pocket. And here I have used the kit from Calco Collage and also printed it a couple pages twice. And I also shrunk down a few pages. So this is also from her. Then I have here a journal card, grungy backed. This is my mason jar. So here's an element from the kit and a mushroom and this leaf. Here we come to the first page from the planner. It says this week's, it has priorities Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, to do, goals, appointments, habits, and I don't know what this is. And I printed it all on coffee. I printed coffee stained paper on the back side of this page, and then the planner thingy on top. So this is not from Calco Collage, this is something else. Yeah, this is, I love this. So here a ruffle from the same fabric as this cover is. Here coffee stain printed and a fern stenciled. Little grungy lined paper with a grunge, I stained it through a stencil. Here's the other side from the first week, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. Cross shopping next week. And and here's a fabric pocket and this. And then I made this little scallop pockets and I added quotes. I don't pull now all the quotes out because the quotes are for the person who will receive this journal. But it's all autumn themed, nature themed, and it has something from Aristotle, from, I believe, Rumi. Very, inspirational, I think. So, here on this back side, this is coffee stain paper. I have stamped these lines with a corrugated cardboard. By the way, the week. Here's the rest of the week. Here's the tab with leaf charm. Next week, here this stencil, this pattern is from a stencil from Linda Israel. I have coffee stained a page, then put the stencil on top, and then I have coffee stained again and let it dry in the sun. This is one of the fold out pages that I usually like to add. Idea of Terry Wood. And here I made a tag myself. This is from an Ecodite printable masterboard piece, and it's very, I have added twigs and leaves and dried tea, and I made this collage. Again, stamped lines. Here's one of my little mushroom embellishments that she liked. And this page from Calco Collage. And here we come to the Ecodite paper, the original, not printed. And here I made out of a window envelope a pocket. I have collaged a little bit. This is a little butterfly from Calco Collage kit. So, and then I made this card, stuffed in there. So you can see the bird here. Lots of sewing, ruffles all over the place. And here this fabric tuck, I would say. I have added a couple of these tags. They are on thin, very thin cardstock. I've stenciled here this autumn themed, and I wanted to repeat butterflies because the kit has butterflies, and so I stenciled this. Here again another scalloped pocket with a quote. More planner pages. Here is on this fabric tab is attached a fox. So, and here this little with the four leaves and some ferns and butterfly. Some very light script stamping in the background. Very grungy page. Planner page. Planner page. Lined paper. And here on this page I have stenciled the woods. The deer in the woods. Again, ruffle. Here I made this tag pockets out of parchment paper that's fern stamped. Here's a little mushroom embellishment and one of the tags I made. Again, a masterboard piece from me, very textured and collaged, and this on top. A little scrappy embellishment, and I always try to use pieces from this. From this kit, some stenciling, planner, here's a doily. This is again a little embellishment here in the corner, and this pocket I have sewn here on this page, and I have included here. So the kit is called Autumn Ride. That's why you have always the bicycles. I think it's a very very lovely thing to think about with a bicycle through the autumn, the gorgeous autumn, to drive, and I think it's really great. Here, this is from Calco Collage about bicycle, and an embellishment with mushrooms from me, a fabric pocket, quote, and this is the bingo card. Planner page, and on this tab I added a snail, more planner, mini embellishment, This is the center of the first signature. She can also journal here. So lots of room to journal, to plan. Here I make a triple pocket that is now four pockets. 1, 2, 3. And then in the back side you have here. And I've added here little bits and pieces. Another one of this tag pockets with this tag I made. Here's some stenciling again, and always the ruffles here, a little scrappy embellishment, and this tuck. And I made this one, this tag, and I added again a quote here, so you see why there's this fluffy things on the edge, because I let it overhanging. I think it's cute, a mushroom embellishment, some frame, more stenciling. So lots of work, but I really enjoyed it. Tough order, but I think I got it done. Here's a little bell. Another one of the fold-outs. Tag I made. Another one. Mini tiny mushroom embellishment, grungy printed coffee stained paper with the planner page on top. More planner pages. So 25 weeks all in all. Excuse me. More eco-dyed paper from me, original. And here this was from Calco Collage, this library pocket, and here the fox from this kit, and I have put it here on this red leaf. I think I can call it faux leaves because it is not really fabric. It's I think it's something plastic-ish, but I like them. It feels a little bit like fabric. I don't know. Some more fern stenciling, and here another window pocket with this image here in their journal card. Gosh, I really hope she loves it. So here's a leaf attached, leaf charm. Another quote in this scallop pocket, and here it says, ooh, where's my light? It says notes, and this other one of them. Some more wood stenciling with deers. And I think we are on now over the half. We have more than the half. This little mushroom embellishment. These are also, let me show you, tucks. But I thought I need to let at least a little bit space for the person who gets this journal to tuck something from her in there, not fill everything. This page is reinforced with washi. I thought it's better. Again, the stencil pattern from Linda Israel. More planner pages all over the place, and here is added another bunnies, a little mushroom embellishment, and here again one of the large pockets, another one of this excuse me stencil tags and this I made then. Here this, it's a belly band. I've used this large bicycle and I have collaged here a belly band, and I put one of the tags behind the center of the fourth signature, another embellishment, and this is bicycle dictionary thing from the kit. Here I've added on this. This is now a triple pocket. It has three pockets. Just a little bit of washi. It was too plain, but I don't want it to add too much. And here, these are all shrunk down little embellishments. Now, how you call it? Ephemera. I'm losing my words. Planner pages, and that's now the here this is added with washi, and you can fold it out or you let it this way and then you can skip it so this way, so we have something a little bit hidden. It's this page is a little bit hidden under this I don't know if it makes sense. So you can write your journal, and if you wish, you can use it with a paper clip and close it. So a little bit of a hidden space. Another one of this little mushrooms with the tag pockets. Planner page. Again, a scrappy embellishment with a tuck. Again, all the little mushroom, she wanted mushroom embellishments. She get a lot of mushroom embellishments. I can make mushroom embellishments. Yeah, and this ruffle. And I think the first when I saw the kit, I thought, oh, that doesn't work with my fabric. And so, oh God, panic. But no, it works. I've just added a ruffle. So to get the connection between all these leaves, the fabrics, and the kit, I think it works. Mini tiny embellishment. Here is a squirrel. Ooh, yeah. And quote. Some stenciling again from a window envelope. This was junk mail, and I've covered it up with a collage.
Oh, sorry.
I'm so sorry. And this, I shrunk down a page to make more journal cards. I believe yes. More eco-dyed paper, original from me. Fern stenciling. And again, a tuck. And here is the little acorn. Added. So I wanted to make sure that when she has to fill the planner, that she also have a space for notes. And it should be grungy. I think that's grungy. One more time, the deers in the wood. And one of the last overhanging leaves here and embellished. And the back pocket. Oh, I did forget to mention something. This and this. They are also pockets. I haven't filled them. I don't think I wanted to. Or maybe I will put a mini tiny envelope there. So there's a pocket. And oopsie. And there. I'm not sure if I want to fill it or let her fill it. So. And that's the back pocket with a journal card.
and a tag. And that's the best planner I ever made so far. And it's also my first one. So let me close this mumbo jumbo big dude. I hope she likes it. It's chunky. Yeah. I can chunky. So this will go out. What day do we have today? I think on maybe on Friday. Again. So that's the planner I made so far. The best one. I hope you like it. The kit is in the description box. I hope to see you soon. Thanks for watching. Have a fabulous day. Bye bye.